Hey there, how are you? When you look at the Dynamics 365 offering, one thing you may notice is the absence of a timesheet solution. There is one actually, but it's part of project operations, meaning that if you are working with CRM only, you don't have access to this tool. And if you ever looked for a solution in the Power Apps space, I'm sure you have found a lot of Canvas apps to deal with it. But what about the timesheet that you can use within the Dynamics 365 model-driven apps look and feel? My name is Jorge Daniel, and in this video, I lay ground for a model-driven app timesheet. To start a model-driven app project, you should first think of your data model. Keep in mind that we will be using Dataverse, which means that we already have a lot of things in place, such as record ownership or record status. With that in mind, let's look at what we need to custom build. I like to start simple and small. So just open Notepad and let's start to design what will be the ground of our solution. Users will be filling in timesheets. So that can be our first table. And for this one, for the time being, let's have a primary column and a date column. With the timesheet created, users can now start to enter time. So let's have a time entry table. And in this one, we will need a relationship with the timesheet table. And I believe that having a choice for a type of time entry will be useful as well. And we can maybe also make a relationship with an account. And let's have a date column also here. Now that type of time entry column, we can make it a choice column, as I said, and we can have choices such as work, absence, or vacation. I see a lot of other things we can have in this solution, maybe projects, maybe entitlements or some other kind of customer service agreements, maybe work related to orders. But as I said, let's start to lay the ground for our solution. Let's start simple and small. Let's build this. Okay, so I have here an empty, as much as it can be empty, environment, and it has a Dataverse database. So let's start with a new solution. And let's create a new publisher. So do avoid the default publishers that are provided. And let's do your company name. Here it's much the same, but with no spaces. And let's have a prefix, your company name. And I like choices to be this way. Now we can select it and create. One thing I know is that I'm going to reference the table account, so I'll start right there and pull in a reference for that table, and I want to bring it in with no object selected. I'm going to start by building the choice column, since I know I'm going to need it when I build the time entry table. So let's go here with choice. I want a new one, not an existing one. And this is time entry type. And my choices are work, absence, and vacation. It's done. Now let's have a new table, and this is the time sheet table. Let's leave the primary column as name and let's save it. And the other table we need is time entry. The primary column for time entry, it can also be name. And then we need a few more columns here. Okay, let's start with the lookup for timesheet. And save. We now need the type, and this is a choice that will be syncing with time entry type. Save. Now a lookup to account. Also a date column. Okay, date and time. I want date only, and okay. Also in the timesheet table, I will also want a date column. Okay. Time, date only, and okay. As I said, I like to start simple and slow. Maybe get a nap running, see if the bases are working. So let's spin up an app. And get our tables here and see if it's working as it should be before we start to grow our solution. So, diverse tables, and we are looking for timesheet, time entry, and let's add this. Okay. Save and publish the app. That's done. Let's now configure a couple of forms for the timesheet. Nothing too fancy at the moment. Okay, owner always goes well there. A name and a date. Okay. And for the time entry table forms, the owner can go there. Let's maybe split this into a couple of columns. So name, date, type. Now I see I forgot a very important thing, the duration column. We are going to need to add that. Well, timesheet, maybe account here. Okay, and let's hide this label. And save and publish. Let's add that column duration because, well, I think that that one is really important. So let's go back. Tables, time entry, columns, new column, and duration. Okay, and number duration. So we are not really making columns required, not configuring any business rules or other workflows, but we'll have time for that. So let's just lay the ground for the moment and see if it makes sense or not. So let's go back to the form. And let's add the duration. Okay, maybe here. And this one, it may be go there. And publish. Okay. Also, what might be nice would be to have a subgrid of time entries in the timesheet. So let's make let's go back to this form and open it. Split this in two. Maybe make it a 3070. Okay, and enter here a subgrid. Show related. Okay, for the time being, we have this default view only. Okay, let's hide this label and maybe This one we can rename to time entries. Nice. Publish. Okay, let's try this out. Let's play the app. Okay, let's create a new timesheet. Okay, demo one, today's date, save, and now we can add some time entry here, demo time. Work and maybe 3 hours, and this should be good for testing. Still a lot of work to be done here, from little things like when you click this new time entry button, some of the fields can be filled in automatically. Also, some more granularity when you select work, and we can maybe have a work type option and tie that with other dimensions such as projects, customer service entitlements, or sales orders. And of course, we can have icons for our tables, make the forms look better, and work on the views. All in all, I think we can use this basic start and build on it to make a solution that can cover different work scenarios and also allow for time entry report. If you have any suggestions, I would love to hear about them, so just use the comments to get through. And I hope you liked this video and maybe it has helped you in some way come up with some new ideas. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you soon!